Ah, 2025, the year that is predicted to cost people worldwide tens of trillions of dollars due to the rampant growth of hacking attacks of all calibers. So here's the deal. I bring you the best antivirus tier list so that you know how to protect yourself in this treacherous time, and you just gotta watch through it. To begin with, I am gonna highlight three things for each provider today: security, features, and pricing. Now that that is established, here's my board prepared just for the occasion. So let's start. The first provider I'll be covering today is TotalAV. This antivirus has always received considerable attention from independent auditors at AV Test and AV Comparisons. I've seen it grow over the years, and today this provider has some of the best malware detection rates in the industry. I tested it myself, and these full scan results are above any other competitor. TotalAV doesn't have the smallest CPU usage during scans. It reaches as far as 90% at times, but the scan itself took only a bit over 10 minutes. That's a trade-off I'm willing to take, but scans are far from the only important element of an antivirus: real-time protection. Antiviruses rely on it to prevent malware from getting on my PC, and TotalAV's RTP is easily in the top three, according to my testing. TotalAV is relatively standard in terms of features. So the most significant upsides, of course, are ransomware protection, an ad blocker, a VPN, and cleanup and optimization tools. Not a lot, and to be completely transparent, the VPN is relatively lackluster compared to other big names. You won't find any exciting, unique features. The price reflects that. Now, TotalAV is currently amongst the most affordable antiviruses, even more so if you have a TotalAV coupon code like the one you can get through this QR code or the link in the description. As far as antiviruses go, TotalAV is a perfect budget option. It's reliable, fast, secure, and affordable, which is enough reason for me to put it on the S tier. The next contestant, Norton, is a bit different, but not when it comes to security. Norton has been receiving some of the highest grades from independent audits for years. Even in my own tests, I noticed that Norton performs just as well as TotalAV while using less CPU. Even in terms of real-time protection performance, Norton is barely different, taking a close fourth spot in my test. No, Norton's abundant features list is what makes it stand out the most, even among the best antivirus apps. Remember all the goodies that I've mentioned for TotalAV? Norton has those and a bunch of extras on top of that. Among the best things are up to 250 gigabytes of cloud backup, a smart firewall, a dark web monitor for data leaks, identity theft protection, and for US users specifically, social security and credit card protection. Feature-wise, Norton is one of the strongest antiviruses out there. Historically, that made it really hard to use since the UI was close to being a labyrinth. These days though, Norton has fixed many of its UI and UX problems, becoming, well, still not as user-friendly as TotalAV or Bitdefender, but it's much better than it was. So the only real downside of Norton is its pricing. Norton is one of the priciest providers, and I mean, I can't see why. The versatility of all those features doesn't come cheap. While you can, get the Norton coupon code, check my links, or the QR code if you're interested. That said, even with a higher price point and a slightly complicated UI, Norton is easily S tier. It's hard to find an antivirus that provides so many features simultaneously. Now, I mentioned Bitdefender a bit earlier, so let's cover this provider next. As far as best antivirus softwares go, this one has always been a staple, a popular option with high grades from independent researchers. In my own testing, Bitdefender performed a bit differently than I expected. So don't get me wrong, it has the best malware detection rate of all AVs that I've tested. The RTP performance is also on par with that of other top competitors. There's really nothing to complain about. Even the CPU usage during the scans is more liberal than that of TotalAV or Norton. It's just that the scan takes 3 hours on average. Yeah, Bitdefender security is really strong, but not everybody will be satisfied with losing so much time. As far as side features go, Bitdefender is as versatile as you'd expect from a top-notch provider. It has a VPN, a password manager, anti-theft measures, and payment detail protection, pretty much all you'll ever need. Now, I have to note that Norton is still more versatile. There are some features that Bitdefender just doesn't offer if I compare the two. Bitdefender's VPN is very lackluster, so I doubt you could do any streaming or torrenting with it. That said, Bitdefender does get extra points from me for at least being more affordable than Norton. Then again, if you want to have all the features, you're going to have to pay up. Of course, reducing prices is par for the course if you have a Bitdefender coupon code. And if you don't, you know where to look for them. Overall, there's little to complain about when it comes to Bitdefender. This is my personal S-tier candidate to end all antiviruses, one day at least. Unless surprising candidates overtake it. Surfshark is not an antivirus, but a VPN. But just as many AVs have built-in VPN, Surfshark goes uphill both ways.
Ain't a blizzard.
So of course there's the expectation that it would suck. Bitdefender VPN sucks, Norton VPN sucks. Naturally, Surfshark antivirus would also suck, right? No! AV test rated Surfshark antivirus with surprisingly high marks. Some genuine AVs perform worse. My tests, which showed Surfshark's malware detection to outperform TotalAV and Norton, baffled me even more. Still, I can't ignore the very high CPU load and scanning time. It's not as slow as Bitdefender, but it's far from being fast either. As far as basic protection goes, Surfshark antivirus is solid. However, it does lack many features that make providers like Bitdefender indispensable. Sure, there's a VPN that's actually good and can be used for streaming and torrenting. At the same time, there's no firewall, password management, or parental controls, the stuff most top options always offer. It also won't do any good against ransomware, which is on the rampage these days. So the saving grace is the pricing. Surfshark is much more affordable than the majority of other VPNs, never mind antiviruses. Just keep in mind that you can't get Surfshark antivirus as a standalone. It'll always be paired with a VPN. That said, getting it is still a better deal, especially with a Surfshark coupon code. Overall, Surfshark is a solid A. A very strong contender with a promising future. Hey, maybe a new kid will level the playing field, or it'll get overtaken by an older mean kids. Like, this one has been around for decades. It's a true veteran of the antivirus scene, and that shows. So last year, AV Test reported perfect marks across the board for the entire year. Not a single slip up in this age of cybercrime? That's impressive, even for the best antivirus program. I'm even more impressed that my testing backed this info up. It has the second best malware detection results of all the AVs that I've tried. Top one, if you consider the RTP test as well. Sure, it's not as fast because the CPU load is significant, but no sign of stagnation usually persists with older providers. Ah, never mind. It's the features that are the problem. It is quite invasive of your system. Running it on my PC, I benefit from enhanced file protection, encryption of sensitive data, password management, a VPN, and proactive identity protection. Yeah, sounds great, right? Well, yes, I enjoy having so much versatility in one place, but my PC doesn't. It promises you seamless device performance, but in my experience, it's been the opposite. I can definitely tell that it slows my system down. And if that wasn't enough, it drains my wallet. I mean, seriously, in this day and age, it maintains the pricing it had 10 years ago and even gets it higher sometimes. The worst part is that the most inclusive plan starts with 5 users and you have to pay for each one on top, but you can't ask for fewer users to cut the price down. This rigid pricing makes it really hard to recommend to anyone except hardcore security fanatics with top grade PCs. My advice is to consider more lightweight options with lower prices, but if sounds exactly like what you need, this B tier provider will serve you well. All right, my next entry in this list is Malwarebytes. This one strikes close to home. It's a genuine antivirus from the land of the free. Definitely, it's the best antivirus application, right? Not really. Malwarebytes is surprisingly mild. For example, going straight from the AV test, it doesn't have awe-inspiring grades. In my testing, Malwarebytes had one of the worst performances. This is especially disheartening considering it took more than 3 hours to finish a single scan. If that wasn't enough, RTP didn't work for me at all. It didn't catch a single file. Yeah, maybe there's something wrong with my testing, but there was no issue with the other providers. If you have any guesses about why that could be, let me know in the comments. In any case, these days, Malwarebytes is going all out riding the AI hype train. Their AI is promising revolutionary malware detection rates, but I think we can all agree that AI can do more harm than good at times, and I think they still need a lot of polishing. Granted, this provider offers a lot of nice features from a VPN and anti-phishing ad blocker to ransomware protection, spam call blocker on mobiles, and browser protection. It's a good package, but most users value Malwarebytes not for the features themselves, but that they can use them for free. This provider has a basic free version, after all, one that doesn't include a bunch of features, not even real-time protection. That said, one could argue that it serves as a decent first introduction to antiviruses. This is the main reason why a lot of users prefer it. If you want the full feature pack, you are gonna have to cough up quite a bit. Malwarebytes is not that affordable, and if you consider the security downsides, it's just simply not worth the price, in my opinion. If you want an antivirus with a lot of features, it's a B-tier entry, but for me, it's C-tier at best because just the security issues. Next up is Avira. Security-wise, it's a very solid provider, one of the best in the industry. Actually, if you judge by the malware detection alone, AV gave it high grades, and my testing showed that it's comfortably in the top three after Bitdefender and ESET. Now, while the RTP performance is pretty mediocre, at least the malware test didn't take as long as Malwarebytes. Decent results all around. Feature-wise, Avira is just as expected as well. So ransomware protection, firewall, password manager, the usual shebang. Why have I not mentioned Avira alongside all the other best antiviruses? That's because of reputational damage. Yeah, over the years, Avira's free version pretty much turned into adware. In 2022, it was involved in a crypto mining scheme, and even earlier in 2020, the company was bought out by a Middle Eastern company with ties to military hackers. So, here's my point. Yes, Avira has decent pricing, and no, I don't think it's worth it. This is a very misleading provider that can't go further than the C tier, in my opinion. However, when it comes to bad reputations, there's no bigger offender than McAfee. Yeah, I think we are all familiar with its terrible reputation. It's been branded as malware itself. While I can see that it's not bad, I do have problems with the provider. Yes, the AV test showcase does give it good marks in the latest testing, but that's hardly enough. Sure, in my test, McAfee did manage to give decent results in malware scanning, but when it comes to real-time protection, it's just not working properly. Similarly to my experience with Malwarebytes, this RTP simply didn't detect any malware. Now, McAfee does come with additional features, quite a few of them actually, VPN, identity monitoring, password manager, the list goes on. Unfortunately, these features have a very negative impact on my PC. So McAfee's been called bloatware for a reason. Just having it on eats a lot of resources. The biggest downside though is easily pricing. With the controversial nature of this antivirus, the poor performance, and daily long scans, I just don't think it's worth the price, especially when much better providers like Bitdefender are cheaper in comparison. So it goes without saying that McAfee is a D-tier provider. The one provider I think we can all agree on being D-tier right next to McAfee is Avast. Now you might be asking, why? Well, there's a reason I haven't tested Avast and why I think you shouldn't use it regardless of its price or features. The reason is simple. Just last February, the FTC convicted and fined this provider for selling user browsing data behind closed doors. So far, Avast has not done much to regain users' trust, so I just wouldn't be naive enough to give it the benefit of the doubt. So I reiterate, D tier, let's be done with it. So this is it. This is the final tier list. Personally, I recommend you focus on the A and the S providers. These are not only the most secure ones, but they also have the best price to value ratio. If you want to try out the best antivirus 2025 options, remember there are discount links in the description below. All right, thanks for watching. If you have any comments, don't hesitate to let me know. And I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.